Hello, everyone. Welcome back. StarCityGames.com. Baltimore Open weekend. We are in the finals. Cedric Phillips, Patrick Sullivan here in the booth. Nick Miller down the feature match area getting ready to watch Matthew Vuk do battle here against Jonathan Ross, number 4 and number 7 overall seed. It's 4-color woman's Christmas Control. The winner walking out of here with $5,000, 30 SCG Tour points, and an invite to that Invitational. Should be fun to watch as Jonathan Rossum has won an Open earlier this year. Lost in the finals of an Open earlier this year as well for Matthew Vuk. He has already lost in the finals of a Legacy Open previously in his career. Both these players, 20 years old, very good at a young age. Mm. At a very old format with old cards, too. Makes it a little more impressive.
And weird interactions and...
all of it. For Rossum, he's going to kick things off there with the Badlands. Vuk is sacrificing that windswept teeth on Rossum's end step, trying to figure out exactly which land he wants to get. It's going to be a scrub land. Four-color loam kind of coming back now onto people's radar because this metagame has changed so much with the exclusion and banning of Deathrite Shaman and Gitaxian Probe. So a deck like this actually can thrive now where it couldn't before. Vuk will play a Dark Confidant. I'd be surprised if that lived, and it won't. There's the Lightning Bolt. We'll go over to John. He has a Polluted Delta in hand. He's going to play that now. That's for sure. For Rossum, this is his 10th top 8 here on the SCG Tour. For Matthew Vuk, this is his second one. Rossum already with the title. Vuk looking for his first. As Rossum will sacrifice that Polluted Delta. Going to fall down to 19. See which land he wants to get here. He does have to worry a little bit about a Wasteland here in this matchup. His deck does have plenty of basics, of course, but he's going to search up a non-basic there in Underground Sea. Perhaps it's time for him to Torak, and it is. So two cards will be discarded at random. And those two cards will bite the dust. We'll find out what those are soon enough, but that'll be Rossum's turn. You got to remember, what this deck does so well that Rossum is playing, it's just 2-for-1 city, grind you into dust. But Vuk can come back from those disadvantages because he's got plenty of card advantage, too, in Punishing Fire and Life from the Loam as he discards a Grove of the Burn Willows and an Abrupt Decay.
So his deck doesn't have a lot in the way of search, which is kind of problematic. But, you know, his card advantage engines, if they're online, and that is.
Yeah. There's your card advantage engine.
Yep.
Wasteland, Life from the Loam.
He has to naturally draw them. He doesn't have a whole lot in the way of search or selection, but when he finds them, they are just steady card advantage for the whole game.
Yeah, it just got a lot harder there for Ross. Well, that'll change it. There's the old Baleful Strix. It just got a lot harder for John. Now he's going to have to take up basics.
What'd you say, 2-for-1 city? There it is.
Yep. No,
2-for-1.
Yeah, there's the island. Because he's got to pivot now and go to the basics with this Wasteland mini-lock that Vuk can put together. I don't expect that Badlands to be long for this world.
And remember that Vuk can actually create a full lock given enough time because there's Ghost Cord in his list as well.
John will draw there from the Baleful Strix. We'll head back over to Matthew, who will dredge 3. Huh. That's a hit on the old bingo board. Finally! I just need someone to play an invention, please. That'll cap off a great weekend. There's the loam. Get back the Wasteland. You see the plan. Pretty obvious.
Yep. And if Vuk can find the Ghost Quarter, then it's huge, huge trouble.
He finds the Ghost Quarter or he finds a Punishing Fire, right, to kill that. I mean, the Strix is not really pressuring him or anything, but I think we're going to see him continue to dredge to maybe try to find a Punishing Fire or that Ghost Quarter, as you mentioned. And it's not like he doesn't have stuff to do in the meantime. And his life total is not under duress.
So Rossum, I think from his end, the big draw here is a black source of mana.
Yes.
Because if you can get the Gurmag Angler on the battlefield, then Vuk doesn't really have the luxury of just sitting around playing with his food.
Which is absolutely what he's doing right now, is there's a Windswept Teeth. Vuk's going to sacrifice that. Fall down to 17, Will Matthew, as he set up a nice early stages of this game. That's a Bayou.
And if he can get a Knight of the Reliquary onto the battlefield, if he gets that to resolve, this one's not quite over, but, I mean, very close.
There's Loam again. Gonna get those. Who's going to, I think, adjust his life total there from the fetch. As you mentioned, for Rossum, right now, you know, he needs to just basically draw a fetch that would allow him to search up a swamp. Kolagon's Command's not what he's looking for, so he'll just attack for one. We're going to go back over to Matthew now. Matthew going to dredge again. I think he might just be aggressively searching for that Ghost Quarter, as you mentioned.
Or just even things like Mazavith start cutting out a lot of Rossum's lines.
That's a very good point. That's a Taiga.
And also milling himself for three every turn. Gets him a shot at Punishing Fire. Punishing Fire helps him manage the battlefield a little bit. Cuts off Jace as a concern, though unlikely Jace comes into play in this game with Rossum being so constrained on mana.
I'd be surprised if that worked itself into it. Here's a risky Brainstorm. But for John, he needs to find a way to cast something.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely... it's a risky Brainstorm because you get Brainstorm locked, but also casting nothing is very risky here. Yeah.
Jace is going to be put back. It looks like John did find a Bloodstained Mire. That'll be a black source of mana that he's looking for, and that means he'll be able to play that Angler. He's going to attack first here for one. So Rossum has worked himself through this Wasteland lock a little bit here.
Yeah, he can play.
Yep. There's that basic swamp. That's part of the appeal of this Grisk Control deck, too. It's got great mana, but it can afford to play basics of all the colors, basically. Rossum's got two islands and two swamps.
Yeah, I think the first of all, you want some number of basics just to be protected from Wasteland, and I think that's those are the basic land requirements to be able to cast anything through Blood Moon, mm-hmm. because you have him to Torak and Jace the Mind Sculptor.
There's your dredge again. So my question now here becomes, for Matthew Vuk, you're still dredging, but what are you looking for?
Well, I believe he found Maze of Ith, and okay. that's a prize here, because Rossum cannot interact with non-basic lands.
Yep.
So, at least in the first game. So that Maze of Ith is good, and that Angler is now on lock.
Rossum. We'll draw a card. Maze of Ith is going to take care of that Angler. Love the attack there. Well, I guess he has to, right? Because if he doesn't attack with the Angler, then he'll just
Maze
tap
the Baleful
Strix. Yeah, so you got to attack with both, actually. Don't be lazy. Now where does Rossum go from here? Because if he plays that Badlands, he knows that I only get one use out of this card.
Yeah, it's a one and done.
More dredging to be done. Here's Loam again. And Vuk has not found a Punishing Fire just yet. He'll get back a couple of cards there in Wasteland, and looks like a Badland. So his hand is essentially just full of lands. There's a Wasteland that's going to go after that. And it looks like Rossum's going to float some mana. I think it's going to be maybe Snap Bolt, yeah?
Yep, just trying to get some more pressure going.
Just trying to get creative, right? Down to 11 goes Vuk. Vuk might have to shift here, or maybe he stays the course and just really needs to find a Punishing Fire.
Yep. I mean, he's not under that much pressure in the scheme of things. You know, he's fallen to 8 here. If he finds a Punishing Fire, he starts playing cleanup on the little stuff, and not that hard from here.
It's better to dredge 3 than to draw 1, and I think I just found the P-Fire.
Yeah.
All right. There's a land.
Second Grove, too. Not
That's
shabby.
Nice. That's nice. Where's Rossum go now? Does he have a Snapcaster Mage to play on the end step, maybe? Keep trying to chip away. Yeah. He'll untap. He'll draw. Picked up another copy of Brainstorm. Has another Bolt in his hand. He might be able to do this, actually. He's going to start with a Brainstorm, is John. Worth noting, John only playing 2 copies of Lightning Bolt, so he's got to make them all count.
And he doesn't have a mountain in the deck list, which means that when he exposes a Badlands or Volcanic Island, it's gone.
Yep.
So it's not just an issue of finding enough bolts, but being able to do what he needs to do and preserve his access to red mana to be able to cast the bolts. Because he's one and done on his red mana from here.
Yeah.
Vuk is not going to let him get to his main phase.
He'll get back Punishing Fire. Punishing Fire is going to take care of Snapcaster Mage. Maze of Ith will take care of the Angler, and that means Vuk is going to fall down to 5. So Rossum can actually get this done with the combination of Bolt and Kolagon's Command, Patrick.
Yep, but again, the issue there is how many red sources of mana do you have left, and you're not going to get 2 shots with red mana.
Yep.
Although that now, maybe there's a window. Because by not having a wasteland on the battlefield...
He gets two shots at
that
it.
That means Rossum can sacrifice this, go get a Volcanic Island, cast a red spell, untap, and cast a red spell.
Absolutely.
I don't know if there was a different line for Voot to take, but by not casting a wasteland here, he's giving Rossum a shot, two shots with red mana, and that might be all he needs.
And we know Rossum's got a bolt in hand, and he's going to sacrifice this Delta, so maybe John goes for it right now. He'll get a Volcanic Island. This is a Lightning Bolt. Yes, it is. And if John has a Snapcaster Mage in his hand, that's likely the game.
And or Kolaghan's Command.
Yeah, Rossum's already ready to untap. He'll draw. Does he need to top deck? He does not. Kolaghan's Command's going to deal that final two. And perhaps it was not playing a Wasteland that turn that just cost Matthew Vuk. As Jonathan Rossum able to get out from underneath that Wasteland lock and steal that first game. Grixis Control up a game here over four-color Loam.
Yeah, I mean, we were talking maybe a turn or two left before Rossum would have been fully locked out, but able to squeeze out those final 2 points.
We go to the sideboards now for Matthew Vuk. You can see maybe some deep breaths, maybe thinking he let that one get away from him a little bit here, but he's already going to the drawing board. You see 4 Leyland of the Void, 2 Golgari Charm, 2 Thalia Guardian of Thraven, 2 Swords of Plowshares, a copy of the Tabernacle, a Pendril Veil, and a Johnny Vengeant, and Garrick Relentless, Liliana the Last Hope, and Reclamation Sage. A lot of good ones here.
Yeah, I'll take all the Planeswalkers. I like the Thalia Guardian of Thravens in this matchup, and I don't think Swords of Plowshares is necessary. I understand the concern about Gurmag Angler, but I think you can manage that in other ways. The Planeswalkers here. Those are the best parts.
Other side of things here for Jay Rossum. 3 Surgical Extractions, 2 Flusterstorm, 2 Pyroblast, 2 Blood Moon, a Red Elemental Blast, a Pithy Needle, March Casualties, Liliana the Last Hope, Toxic Deluge, and True Name Nemesis.
I like True Name Nemesis in this matchup, the Surgical Extractions as well, and of course the Blood Moons.
Yeah, tough to get away from the Blood Moons, right? Yeah. Though Vuk does have Abrupt Decay, and I think he'll leave them in, there could be a time when the Blood Moon's perfect.
Right, it's not guaranteed to just end the game on the spot, but Vuk has enough vulnerabilities to it, and Rossum has enough inefficient cards to cut as well that I think it makes sense to bring in.
Well, last time we'll talk about this, SCG Con, Winter. We're going to go through the whole thing here as these players get ready here for game number 2. The fun starts on Thursday, folks, hosted at the massive Bowes Point Brewery and Tasting Room in neighboring Daleville, Virginia. SCG Tour 2018 Season 2, $100,000 Invitational Last Chance Qualifier. Modern, limited to 96 entrants, so if you're going to come, make sure you do sign up pretty quickly, and all 5-0s are going to qualify. So just a 5-rounder, you go 5-0, you're in there. You play in that Season 2 Invitational weekend. We're also going to have a match at the Gathering Team Trivia, which we've done before. A lot of fun there. Patrick can certainly vouch for Bowes Point.
I can.
You like that stuff.
San Diego area brewery. I've been down there back when I lived in that area.
Of course. So that's the LCQ and the team trivia that we'll be doing there. We're going to have a lot of artists there, too, of course. We'll have Vulcan Baga, Dan Fraser, Douglas Schuler, and so many more joining us at SCG Con. So if you want to get your card signed and meet some of Magic's greatest artists, make sure you do join us. Boy, we've got playmats aplenty, I believe. Our exclusive playmat here for SCG Con. Commemorative playmat offered in VIP packages and on our fantastic prize wall, which will have plenty of goodies besides this. So if you want this awesome playmat as a commemorative item at the event, make sure you do pick that up. Got a lot of some sealed events here. We got our Uninvitational, our StarCityGames.com History of Ravnica draft that we'll be doing, sealed event, and then the StarCityGames.com Masters limited event as well. So if you're looking for some unique limited formats to play in, we'll have those. Got the Commander Celebration taking place. We've had our Command Zone at many events. This is just another iteration of that. A lot of goodies to be picked up there. The Commander Versus team, along with Benny Smith, Sheldon Menery, and Danny Westby joining us if you'd like to play against those players as well. What else we got? Winter Championships? Sure. Modern, Standard, and Legacy. Those will be 5Ks with some awesome playmats joining them. I think we've got some qualifying events for this awesome Q draft we'll be doing. We'll have 2 Modern ones on Friday and Saturday. A Legacy one on Friday, a Standard one on Saturday. The finalists will qualify for this Cube draft. 8 qualified players will booster draft a fully powered 360-card cube that's designed by Justin Parnell. $10,000 in cash prizes. We'll be covering it too. Me, Todd Anderson, Matthias Hunt, Ryan Overturf, we'll be critiquing those cube picks. We're all very passionate about cube, of course. And then we'll be bringing back Gold Rush 2. Mythic Madness returns at SCG Con Winter. 3 copies of every non-foil mythic rare ever printed will be randomly distributed to participants in various SCG Con related events and activities. head over to starcitygames.com/SCGCon. Register today. Registration is now open for all of our events. Check back often as plenty more exciting SCGCon announcements are still to come. December 7th through the 9th, it's going to be a blast. I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be here sooner than you think. starcitygames.com/SCGCon. Register today and qualify for that invitational so you can be like Aaron Barich and have your own token. Wish you were going, man. It's going to be fun. It's going to be a little cold, too.
I know.
But it'll be fun. Trying to blow it out with these SCG cons, and man, this cube draft is going to be sweet. Parnell's going to cook something nice up, I know.
For sure.
He's going to cook a nice, fully powered cube up for you guys. Justin will be writing an article on the website about that, too, so if you want to know the contents of that 360-card cube, of which every card will be drafted, every single card will be drafted. Black Lotus is going to be in there. The Moxen are going to be in there. It's going to be sweet. And Justin, very passionate about cube, too, so I'm really looking forward to seeing what he puts together for that cube.
Cubes are really fun. I think it's a lot of people who are involved in Magic or other games like to dabble in game design, and a cube is the closest thing that a lot of people get to kind of creating a curated experience, which is what a lot of design is. So people love to play them, and I think it's very cool to create as well.
Matthew Vuk going to be on the play here for game number two. A tough loss there in game number one. Felt like he may have had that one. I liked everything that he was doing there. I liked the aggressive dredging with Life and Loam over and over and over again instead of taking a draw step, trying to find Punishing Fire, Ghost Court, and everything else he was trying to find. Maybe just one little slip up there by not playing the Wasteland that turn.
Yep. And it's not like a lock that Vuk wins the game if he...
Of course.
Because if Rossum just has another red source of mana, then...
Well, that's a good way to get things started. Rossum has a deck that uses the graveyard, of course. Gurmag Angler.
Snapcaster Mage.
Gorgon's Command. All that stuff has just gotten significantly worse as we head back over to Matthew Vuk. Well, that land's gone.
Yeah.
Went over to Rossum. There we go. Make sure you know that's exiled. John going to play a Polluted Delta. He'll pass the turn back over to Vuk. Vuk will play a Verdant Catacombs. He'll sacrifice his Windswept Heath and dig up the land. There's a basic forest. I think you might see him sacrifice that other fetch too. We will. Mm. So down to 18 goes Matthew.
Vuk, very mindful of Blood Moon.
Pretty smart thing to do. Pretty smart thing to be mindful of. There is... the Badlands.
Now, does he have the Loam?
We'll find out in just a moment. He had it in the last game. It would not be a bad spot to have it this game. It's going to be Dark Confidant. Rossum's going to need an answer to that. He's going to sacrifice a fetch land here. Will John get himself a basic island? So John wants to make sure he has some basics as well, not only for his own Blood Moon potentially, but because of Wastelanders. Here's a Brainstorm on the end step.
Interesting here that it's not like the small creature removal is especially good against four color Loam, but out of respect for Dark Confidant, you have to leave a little bit of that in. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think the small creature removal that he'll leave in is Lightning Bolt. And to note, this Brainstorm is in response to the Dark Confidant, so leads me to believe that John is left in some number of Force of Wills, trying to counter it. Unsuccessful. We'll make sure that John actually places all of those cards into his exile. There we are. Vuk reminding him as well, because you cannot get those back. And there's a Swamp. And it's important, I think, for Vuk to remind John of that, not only because, yes, they are exiled, but you don't want John to think that he can play a Snapcaster Mage and get something back when he can't.
Yeah, of course. Or start counting for Gurmag Angler,
exactly,
whatever the case may be.
Baleful Strix here. John will draw a card. Picked up a copy of Jace the Mind Sculptor. Still has another copy of Brainstorm in hand. Trinkle Thicket will be the reveal there for Matthew.
Trinkle Thicket's significant because if Vuk is able to find Life from Loam, that's one of his best ways to protect it against Surgical Extraction. It's just leaving up a green and being able to cycle in response.
Yep. That's Life from the Loam. He'll get those three cards back. be a scrubland, it looks like. Scrubland or savanna?
That's a savanna.
Savanna, thank you. They're close.
They are. And savanna is now the green source of mana that he needs to cycle the tranquil thicket and cover himself against surgical extraction.
Got it. Brainstorm time here for Rossum. 2 and 3. Yeah. For John.
The easiest thing to do is just, you don't have a graveyard.
Yeah.
You will not have one for the whole game.
That's correct.
So whatever that zone is.
It's all the same.
It's the same zone.
Ross, I'm working on putting two cards back here. This brainstorm not quite done resolving yet. John has found the two cards he wants to put back. Now there's a Scalding Tarn. And it looks like John will just pass the turn back. Not going to attack with the Strix because he wants to hold off the Confidant. Baron Moore is going to be the reveal to Dark Confidant. And then now Vuk might consider dredging, but he's actually just going to draw. A Vindicate in hand here for Matthew. Don't think he has any interest in casting that card just yet.
You don't, but I do.
Yeah, of course you do.
I mean, there is some argument for just fighting over the basics. And
Blow up a swamp or an island?
When you have Leyline in the Void here, what's your most likely route to lose this game? It's probably Jace.
Yeah, I buy that.
He's only got two islands in the deck.
Okay.
You have Wastelands for the rest of it.
Okay. You can sell me on
this. I mean, if you have nothing else to do with your if you have something else to do with your turn, then, you know, you can do something else with your turn. But I think there's an argument here for just attacking his mana. When you've got Loam, you've got it covered.
How about Garrick Relentless?
Also awesome here. That'll play.
Ross, I'm going to take a look. We're going to do the same, for those of you unfamiliar, with the Garrick that transforms. Garrick Relentless this first half, 4 mana, 3 loyalty. When Garrick Relentless has 2 or fewer loyalty counters on him, transform him. Garrick Relentless deals 3 damage to target creature. That creature deals damage equal to its power to Garrick, so fighting, and then put a 2/2 green wolf creature token onto the battlefield. That's the first half. If we get to the second half, we can. It's the Vile Curse, of course. And we'll cover that if it shows up. But it doesn't look like it will, because Force of Will exiling Jace the Mind Sculptor, but the entire graveyard's exiled. That's why you see him sit in the same pile. We'll take care of Garrick. Rossum wants to sacrifice Scalding Tarn on the upkeep, so he will. And it was the Veil Curse, pardon me. There's another basic island.
Yeah, I suppose the concern I have with that line is it's kind of the same thing if he has Force of Will. Vindicate a land versus play the Garrick.
Mm-hmm.
There's a window now to resolve Jace the Mind Sculptor, which is the card you're most concerned about. I suppose you have Vindicate back in the chamber, that's probably safer.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. I think you got the Vindicate to take care of
the concern
Jace.
That I have is I think the lines are fairly close in terms of immediate impact versus risk, but you tap out and now your Loam's exposed.
Sure.
Whereas the other route, you're only spending 3 mana, so you get to leave up Tranquil Thicket or Baron Moore.
And so maybe perhaps Rossum is on the hunt for a surgical extraction to eliminate the life and Loam aspect of this
game. I mean, this is probably his one window to do it, mm-hmm. because after that, we untap, Vuk's got access to his cycling lands again, you don't get another shot at it.
Yep. Makes some sense to me. Looks like Rossum still working on this brainstorm here. So that's taken care of. That's Badlands. See where John wants to go next, tapping 3 mana here. Maybe it's time for a Kolaghan's Command.
Could be Blood Moon.
Could be Blood Moon. Didn't even think about that. I mean, he does have Blood Moon in hand. This seems like a pretty darn good spot. He's going to go Kick Command, make you discard. Karak is going to bite the dust. There's the attack for one. Maybe Rossum thinking I can set him up a little bit more with the Blood Moon. Let's see what Vuk does on his turn. Wasteland's going to take care of that. You have to imagine John knew that. See what Vuk's going to do here with the green mana. This is a Zenith, perhaps? He's going to cycle. Okay. Want something new. Picked up a Liliana. Hasn't played land yet for the turn.
Yep. It's still good. You can still play a land here.
Yeah. It's not a bad draw step. Excuse me. Not a bad draw from the cycle.
Assuming that he has black mana.
Mm-hmm. Who's got so many decisions to make this turn? Still got that Vindicate. Still has to decide if he wants to leave Van up for loan because he's got that Baron Moor in hand.
Well, he didn't get Surgical last turn when Rossum had a clean shot at it, so mm-hmm. I don't think it's worth playing around now.
He's going to sacrifice Windswept Heath. Will Vuk. I am mighty curious if John was supposed to play Blood Moon that turn or not. Because now the game has changed some. This Liliana comes down and it resolves. The game has changed.
Yeah. I mean, if he's looking at two cards a turn and he's got shots at Mox Diamond, you know, the Blood Moon may not look that good.
Sure.
I don't know.
There's Lily. That's in. Both players are going to discard. Vuk's cards will go to the graveyard. Rossum's will be gone for good. Rossum going to lose that Bloodstained Mire. Interesting discard. Must mean he doesn't need another land. He'll draw a card. John going to start working on Liliana a little bit here. Not going to get too far. He'll sacrifice that Scalding Tarn. Give himself a Badlands. Now maybe it's time to go to Blood
Moon? I
think so. Okay. Okay. So now Vuk's going to have some difficulty with the spells he plays. Because he's got one green source of mana.
And his hand contains cards like Vindicate.
Mm-hmm. Got a plus here.
It's another argument for Vindicate also. It's
sure.
One of the worst cards if Rossum plays Blood Moon.
Sure.
Whereas your Garrick is still castable.
Still very much castable, yeah. That's a very, very good point. I think Rossum might have Jace here. And
yeah, I mean, he's been setting this up. I mean, he's been setting up this line of play now for several turns.
Yeah, so. You see, and this is what makes it such a joy to watch Rossum play as he Fate Seals himself, is that he's playing turns in advance.
Yeah.
He's planning and he's playing turns in advance.
Well, once you get hit with the turn zero ley line, it's like, okay, a ton of dimensions are cut off.
Mm-hmm.
The win has to be Jace the Mind Sculptor going ultimate.
And now he's going to go to Fate Sealing. He plays that Delta, and Baleful Strix is going to do a nice job of keeping Liliana around three or four counters, though Vuk did draw a good one there in Mox Diamond.
Yeah, that unlocks some of the hand. It doesn't get him anywhere as it relates to Vindicate, though, mm-hmm. because he's missing both black and white mana. And the Baleful Strix is playing a critical role here because one of the ways that Vuk can break out is by going ultimate with Liliana.
Yes. Now Liliana goes down, takes care of the Strix. And now where things get interesting is what happens with Jace? Well, that was answered very quickly. Brainstorm. I was curious if Rossum wanted to keep Fate Sealing or not. And if he did, who he'd want to Fate Seal. Rossum going to now analyze Vuk's graveyard. And he actually has found a copy of Surgical Extraction along with another Blood Moon. Now keep in mind, Blood Moon on the battlefield, so John can't crack a fetch. He's already tapping the fetch for red mana, and he's going to deploy another copy of Blood Moon. So he wants to double up here.
And also get himself to de-handed, because he's not going to be able to keep anything into his hand in the face of this Liliana.
Vuk going to analyze the graveyard here. Again, he's still got that Life in the Loam down there. Not a ton to do with it, of course. This Blood Moon's causing so much trouble. It looks like Chalice of the Void. That's going to be the discard, I believe. Brainstorm again. Looks like Rossum will play a Ponder. And he's going to shuffle right away there. Mystery card coming here for John as he analyzes Vuk's graveyard. Nick Miller will do the same.
Interesting, we've reached a point here. I don't know if they're still in this deck, but the Anglers are approaching being castable.
Just being hard castable?
Yep.
Sure. Not sure how good they are, though, in the face of that Liliana. It might be better than I think.
Well, Rossum has an incentive here to keep the Liliana pinned down a little bit because the going ultimate is a threat.
Mm-hmm. All right. Rossum's ready to discard. Okay, so Liliana, for Rossum, he'll discard that, and Vuk is going to discard a Verdant Catacombs. John will draw. Here's a Ponder. John's going to shuffle. I feel like he's looking for something very particular. I'm not sure what it is.
Or he's just got a ton of... I mean, a lot of his draws just aren't very good right now. Like, he's playing against Liliana, so anything reactive is going to be a pretty easy card to shuffle away.
Or an easy discard, whatever. Yeah. I'm right there with you. John will draw from Ponder. I guess I was expecting to see him Fate Seal and try to just win the game that way.
Yeah. I mean, the goal here might be to accumulate enough cards to buffer against the Liliana and then go ultimate with Jace. Oh, looks like he's picked up True Name Nemesis. Yeah. Now, he still can't do anything with that just yet, but if he can find a second creature to pair with it, that could be an answer to Liliana as well.
There's a land past the turn by. Like, what's interesting here is it feels like Rossum has sculpted a game plan with the Blood Moon and killing Dark Confidant and getting Jace on the battlefield to allow Jace to do its thing. He's done that. I'm just curious what he's trying to set up now as he discards a Surgical Extraction. Okay. Vuk will play a Mox, discard Baron Moore, pass the turn back. Rossum's drawn a card, he's brainstorming again. Guards back. Whoa. Angler.
Boom.
Yep.
What a deal.
Okay. Decay is going to take care of one Blood Moon. Plus. Actually, minus. Pardon me. Vuk will pass the turn back. His turn's simple. Go back over to John. Brainstorm again.
I mean, Rossum is now accumulating enough extra cards here. Or he can actually keep some stuff back. He can hold on to reactive cards for a few turns in the face of Liliana. Now he can also, if he still has his Trinity Nemesis, now is a good window to cast it. Because it's either the Liliana's gone either way.
Yep, well, he agrees with you. There is the true name.
If Vuk edicts, it's off the battlefield. If he goes plus, the true nemesis finishes off in combat.
Mm-hmm. That answers that.
And that was really the only thing, I think, ooh, keeping...
Vindicate the other Blood Moon. But Rossum has the counter spell and Force of Will.
Although that's something of a win for Vuk. I mean, he now has colored mana unlocked. He's drawing to a lot of cards.
Mm-hmm.
But of course, Rossum still with Jace, and Blood Moon cuts out a lot of Vuk's deck.
Will Rossum Fate Seal? Yes. And I like it.
Yep. Now that Vuk is actually on empty,
yep,
there's nothing.
I like it. He puts a card to the bottom, though. Rossum with a Jace in hand. Vuk, is he going to go dredging now?
I think it's really good to dredge in the spot because you can get some cycling lands back, and you have the color mana to cycle now.
Liliana of the Veil would have been the draw step. Looks like Baron Moor, Tranquil Thicket.
Doesn't matter what the third one is, you're still under Blood Moon.
Mm-hmm.
But these lands you can cycle.
He can find some goodies cycling via Mox Diamond. There goes Baron Moor, new card coming. Wasteland will be the land for the turn. We go back over to Rossum. Rossum's going to brainstorm with Jace. Not going to Fate Seal this time. Knows that with the cycling lands and the loam in the equation, that's just not going to work.
Yeah, you can't leave a dead card on top.
Cycle again. I guess the one thing that Rossum would do Fate Sealing-wise is Fate Seal himself. But I'm not sold that gets him anywhere. Vuk's going to dredge loam. Chalice among them. There is a scrub land.
Although I don't know, I'm starting to think maybe Rossum should have been Fate Sealing himself, as you mentioned, because now it feels like, now with the Golgari Charm and the Blood Moon, it feels like Rossum's not going to be able to hold on to this game even by Jacing. Like Vuk is starting to just...
He's starting to find stuff.
Just
now.
Overpower, right? the lock pieces that Rossum has access to. Yeah. And you might have to just make a mad dash
To the ultimate here.
Yeah.
That's what it's kind of felt like is the brainstorming. I'm not sure what it was accomplishing. Like, it definitely accomplished something because it got the Liliana off the battlefield because he was able to build up a bigger hand. But then it's just like, I feel like the way he's going to win this game is with Jace's ultimate. I do not feel like the way he's going to win this game is by dealing damage with creatures.
Right.
And now that both Blood Moons are gone, John's going to continue...
And he's going to have to play through Loam the whole time because Vuk's going to be able to keep a Cycler back in his hand the whole way.
So he's never going to get to Surgical it.
Yeah.
And I know we put a lot of the focus here on Jonathan Rossum. It's a credit to Vuk for knowing exactly what he's trying to accomplish here. Yep. He went from dredging to not dredging to now dredging again and shifting accordingly. He might continue to dredge here. He knew what the cards were to get himself out of the situation, and then he had to draw to Mox Diamond. It's very clear he knows how to play this deck. Liliana going to go up to 4. You know, he saved his Vindicate to try to get a Blood Moon off the battlefield. He failed, but he had a plan for that Vindicate.
Yep.
Vuk is going to dredge again. Now, I do wonder how many cards are left in Vuk's deck. Obviously, we're not going to get that information. We're just going to try to be cognizant of it, as he's probably through... half his deck now, if I had to guess. There is Loam. I think he picked up a Punishing Fire somewhere in the equation That'll be answered, obviously, as you see what he targets. And it looks like, okay, he's thinking, all right, it's time to go after your lands again now. Which is a slow way to go about doing things, but it might be an idea to try to put that stranglehold on Rossum.
Well, I mean, Rossum's got all the mana in the world to work with here at this point. I don't know if there's a lot to be gained by going after his lands. I mean, if it comes up that it's free, then great. I would prefer to try to get to Punishing Fire and try to focus on keeping the Planeswalkers off of going ultimate.
Going to discard a Wasteland. Going to play a Wasteland, Wolvuk. Looks like it might be a Snapcaster Mage. All right. That's just a 2-1. A little bit of pressure there, though, as Rossum's going to sacrifice this Bloodstainmire, give his deck a little bit of a shuffle, get a land out of his deck. I do agree with you. He's got plenty of lands to work with at this stage, and Wastelanding every turn is pretty darn slow.
Yeah, I'm guessing Fuchs mana is actually more valuable to him at this stage than the other way around.
Rossum will draw for the turn. Pithing Needle. Brainstorm here. I feel like this might be a long one. I mean, it hasn't disappointed. It's been a very interesting game.
Definitely.
Fatal Push among the cards that are going to go back. And remember, Rossum has done all of this with no graveyard, which is pretty impressive. But Vuk has fought back when he had access to only a single green mana.
Taking a look at the graveyard here. And, another way for Rossum to maybe manage things from here is to try to go ultimate with Liliana and let the Jace be just a source of raw card advantage.
Assuredly, yeah. Baleful Strix. Fatal Push the draw there. Well, for Rossum, too, there's not a ton he can do with the Lily.
Yeah, there's nothing to kill.
There's no minusing to be done either, you know? So the plan here almost certainly is see if I can get to 7, make the zombies go that route. That'll be difficult for Vuk, potentially. I mean, it's funny because Vuk does have the ability to fight the zombies with Punishing Fire, depending on what his setup is.
So I think Rossum is now taking a look here to see if there's another cycling land left in hand. And if he's picked up a Surgical Extraction, it might be a moment where the shields are down.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he cycled the Baron Moor, so that's on the stack. And if the Trinkle Ticket's in the graveyard, he took a draw step. Okay. So that means that the Trinkle Ticket's still in hand.
Yeah.
It must be. And now here comes your Dredge. 3 cards. Wasteland, Sylvan Library among them.
Is it possible that Vuk has cut the Punishing Fires?
Well, I believe he has one in his hand.
Oh, he has one in hand. Okay, he's gone through just so many cards.
Yeah, I mean, the question is how many does he have left in his deck? How many is he left in for the matchup? I mean, it's the best way for him. If his deck is online, it's the best way for him to check the Planeswalkers.
Yeah.
So I'd be surprised if he skimmed on them. Yep, Baron Moor, Tranquil Thicket.
I guess we're going to get the same 3 back.
Mm-hmm. Baron Moor, Tranquil Thicket, Wasteland. Those are the ones that come back there for Matthew. Two 20-year-olds playing some high-level magic right now. Because there goes... Okay, he's going after him. Cutting the red sources. Okay.
Does Rossum have any red mana left in the deck?
Let's take a look. Good question, partner. Two Badlands, 2 Volcanic Islands.
I mean, I can see that both the Badlands are gone, and so are both the Volcanics.
Okay, well, that answers that question.
Yep.
I wonder what's that cut out of his deck, though.
I mean, at this point, probably very little with both of the Blood Moons already cast.
Mm-hmm. Ross, I'm still getting information. Checking out that graveyard. Maybe the prize with the surgical is just punishing fire.
Yeah. That might be Rossum's position here might just be let him dredge all he wants. And if he doesn't have punishing fire, he actually can't win in time.
Well, game has changed because of the chalice on one. So surgical is not good anymore. Assuming that Matthew remembers the triggers on his chalice.
And he's cut off red mana for the whole game, so now Kolaghan's command is offline.
It's offline,
as well.
Yep. What a back and forth between these two. Tranquil Thicket will be cycled. Draw a card. The biggest question now is how does Matthew win this game? As Rossum will draw. He's going to Fate Seal.
Yeah, we're back to this.
Yeah. There's an attack for 3. Jace on 9. Liliana on 6.
Yeah, with no red mana and Chalice on 1, there's just not a lot to be done with brainstorming.
There's
so many of your cards.
Find.
Yeah, yeah, you're running out of cards that matter.
Cycle the Barrenmoor. Matthew now has 2 copies of Punishing Fire in hand. Looks like he might be casting one. And Matthew wasn't willing to do so, in my estimation, until Surgical Extraction was off the table.
And Kolaghan's command. I mean, it's safe now.
Now he'll dredge Loam again. Still hasn't seen a Grove. There's a Grove.
There we go. Now the engine is starting to get online.
Looks like it might be Thicket Moor and Grove of the Burn Willows.
And he's tapping.
And Rossum is going to tap it out. Matthew Vuk just played a very good game of Magic, folks. As we're going to get ready here for a third and final one between he and Jonathan Rossum. His 4-color Loam just tied things up against Grixis Control. This kid knows how to play his deck.
Yep. I think what's interesting to me there is from Rossum's position, there is a weird sort of back and forth between brainstorming and Fate Sealing.
Maybe a little too indecisive.
And like my instinct was he's kind of like wriggling his way out of these locks that you've set up. You've just got to make a run to the door, try to get to the ultimate, and hope that he can't cobble together enough of an engine before that happens.
Yeah.
And Rossum went up a little bit, then brainstormed, then went up a little bit, then brainstormed, and I think my intuition there was just try to go straight for the ultimate.
Well, we're going to watch game number 3 in just a moment here. We're going to hear a couple words from our sponsors, a few ads from our friends over at Ultimate Guard, and then one more game to crown a champion here in Baltimore. One more for it all. How's that sound?
I'm up for it.
Yeah.
Been a long time since I've covered this amount of Legacy. Been a nice top eight.
It has been. It really has been.
We covered Goblins multiple times in the Swiss.
Yes, we have.
Multiple times.
That was fun, too.
Mono Blue, Painter Servant in top eight.
True. Forgot about that. And now we just got these two players left in the room, and this is truthfully here in the Baltimore Convention Center about it.
Oh, it's a few vendors left. Star City Games wrapping up here.
And Jody Keith out here grinding.
Yeah, Jody Keith out here just battling.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he's playing in, but I see the Pelicans hat over there. He's grinding. He's always on his grind.
Handful of staff. Steve Swanger.
He's head judging.
Nick Miller.
Yep.
Two competitors here. One last game.
And it should be a good one if these first two are any indication, because they've been fun so far, and they've been different, and this matchup is pretty deep and complex.
And that game in particular was really back and forth.
Yes. Yes, it was.
And it's interesting, you know, the impact of the ley line. It just narrows down the range of ways Rossum can win the game. He becomes very much just a Planeswalker control deck.
Yeah. And he's mulliganing this hand. See if Matthew wants to keep his seven or not.
And to go back to what I was speaking to about game two, I don't know about, does the line of just Fate Seal every single turn, you or him, who cares, and try to go to the ultimate. I don't know if that's a winning line. But you're looking at that Jace at seven for a bunch of turns, and you wonder, was the maximum amount extracted from that card?
It's a legit question. It really is.
Because you either cost yourself some cards or you cost yourself some pressure getting into the ultimate. And for Vuk, again, really well-scripted game, and much the same as in the top four, knew exactly what the game was about and held a bunch of cards in his hand to prevent Rossum from being able to break out of the chalice lock.
There's the ley line again to get things started. Grove of the Burn Willows. Mox Diamond. Oof, oof.
That's a draw.
Oof, boy.
That's a draw.
No graveyard and a chalice? Jeez. Well. Rossum fights right back.
Although, if Vuk is without Loam, you know, he's expended a lot of cards this way.
Yeah.
And if Rossum has one of his Kolaghan's commands, things might be okay.
Yep.
If Vuk has Loam to go along with all of this,
this gets tough.
Really, really bad news.
Ross may draw on a card here in just a moment from that Baleful Strix. Looks like he's got another one in hand, too. He's going to have to do pretty good here because he's behind, it appears. Pass that turn back. Let's go over to Matthew. How good is his hand this game? He's had a phenomenal start. There's another Grove. Pass the turn back.
Okay. Well, that's one problem avoided.
At least for now. Okay. That is a way to do it, depending on if Punishing Fire is here or not. In for one. How risky do you have to get here if you're Rossum? Because Rossum does have Liliana in hand, and he could certainly say, I'm just going to try to get to this. He'll play a Tarn. Pass that turn.
Well, I love Rossum's play there because playing the second Strix really lets you suss out the situation. If he's got the Punishing Fire, you're going to see it right then.
Yeah, he'll fire it off.
And you can hold off on the Liliana until you have Surgical Extraction or some other way to fight it. Mm-hmm. If he doesn't, Kos is probably clear.
Okay, well, there's Loam. Baron Moore is returned. Rossum going to untap those two lands. He'll take a draw. Picked up a copy of Force of Will. In for two. At this stage, you know that there's no Punishing Fire. You're afraid of it being dredged into.
But we saw, you know, if there's any, you know, critique you want to make of Rossum in game number two, it seemed like some amount of indecision or uncertainty about, can I play a super deep game with Loam?
Yeah.
Can we go for 25 turns? What does that look like? And I think there's probably, after that second game, an acknowledgement of, Not really.
Yeah, generally the answer is no.
Generally no. Yeah. And I should be willing to risk a little bit here, try to get the game over with.
Here's Loam again. So Vuk is going to pivot a little bit here as he wastelanded that volcanic island to maybe just wastelanding some more. Baron Moore, wasteland. And a fetch. Looks like he'll be attempted to be returned. That'll resolve. I don't think Matthew has anything else to do this turn. I believe his land drop was already made because of the wasteland, so now we head back over to John. John will draw. Picked up an underground sea. Does have a brainstorm in hand.
I mean, I think that's just for the force of will.
At least for now.
Squaring off against the chalice, yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, he's just got to hope he can counter some clutch spell or a loam or punching fire at the right time.
Dredging. P-fire in there?
Yes.
Yes, it is.
Okay. Abrupt Decay as well for Vuk. Very important piece of the puzzle.
That's a nice one to have. This four-color loam deck is this weird combination of cards and numbers and lands and spells and everything else, but it all just kind of works. Rossum will draw. Drew a Surgical.
And we'll see. I mean, is Vuk going to put the shields down here at any point? I would doubt it. With two groves, it's pretty easy to keep the Punching Fire safe.
Mm-hmm. Fire that off. Ooh.
Oh, well, there's a window.
There's the window. I was pretty sure he had Surgical.
Oh, he's got the chalices on one.
Oh, you're right.
Yep,
never mind. On one. Yep, you're right. Jeez.
Yeah, just a lot of lock pieces
yep.
here. Hard to keep track of all the lock pieces.
Yeah, you're right.
Can he snap? No, he's got no graveyard. Yep. Can he get? No, there's
nope.
a chalice.
Yep, yep. No, you're right. Surgical doesn't matter. This kid's played this deck well.
Yeah, this has been... I mean, there's been maybe small pieces of individual plays where I've thought, you know, maybe do something different. But in terms of having a cohesive game plan, of understanding what the game is about and executing on a game plan, I think Matthew's played a really nice set of games.
Yeah, me too. Me too. And there hasn't been a lot of indecision. You know, I'm trying to dredge to get to Punishing Fire, trying to get mm-hmm. to this or that. Or, okay, I got to take draw steps to find Mox Diamonds. I need to hold lands for those Mox Diamonds. You know, I need to keep this Vindicate. I have Abrupt Decay and Golgari trying to get myself out of this Blood Moon situation. It's been pretty cohesive, as you mentioned. Liliana, up to 7. Yep, time to do this. Punishing Fire, this is what Punishing Fire is so good at.
And, you know, you might say, well, there's an Abrupt Decay. Why wouldn't you just, you know, what's going on there? Saving the Abrupt Decay for Blood Moon.
Mm-hmm.
Taking no risks. This Liliana does nothing as long as it doesn't go ultimate.
Yeah, it's a Texas card.
Right, you can just kind of every three turns Punishing Fire it and manage it that way. It's totally fine. Rossum here sitting on his fetch lands, trying not to commit them because he wants to be able to land a Jace should he draw one.
Yeah, but even Jace is getting worse now.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah, because just, of Punishing Fire.
Well, Leyline of the Void's in play, so his deck is nothing but Planeswalkers and bad creatures.
Mm-hmm.
So...
there's another chalice for one.
Some insurance against Kolgon's command.
Yep. And John taking a look at a Force of Will here. He's got Force of Will plus Brainstorm. He can counter something.
And now, you know, Rossum, this is another fork in the road moment of, do I just say, resign myself, I'm not playing any one-cost spells for the remainder of the game, or do I hope to be able to draw to Kolgon's command? And it looks like he's going to take one more draw.
Oh, Rossum will draw. I think that was K Command.
That was.
All right. One more. Down to 10. Plus Liliana. Pass the turn back. P-fire that. he needs him to tap wrong.
Yeah. Because you could Kolaghan's command, you know, Kolaghan's command plus surgical yep. if he just leaves himself. But as long as he's got the two groves up, yep. it doesn't work.
He needs him to tap wrong. Ain't going to happen. Yep. Oh, I love it when they're too smart.
Yep.
Would have been so easy to tap wrong there. Back to Matthew. He's playing his ass off right now. It's yeah, unbelievable. Yeah,
clutch it. Still got his abrupt decay clutched here, so he's covered against Blood Moon. He's got Punishing Fire that I don't think Rossum can realistically touch. So going ultimate with the Planeswalkers isn't getting anywhere. And I'm just not sure how Rossum proceeds.
He needs him to make a mistake.
Yeah.
I mean, and I don't think he's going to cooperate.
Yeah. As long as he just keeps managing it like this, there are going to be spots where it looks like Rossum is making forward progress, that he's doing something,
mm-hmm.
and that's not really the case.
There's a Scrubland.
Yeah, and we're sort of seeing a lot of, I think, some of the same elements that we saw in Game 2, where it looks like Rossum can kind of hang around in these games that are going a million terms, but...
But not really.
But not really. It would be different, not for Leyline of the Void.
Yes.
But it's just so many dimensions of the deck are cut out.
Yep.
And if you narrow down the game to just about the Planeswalkers... And then Fu can manage that with Punishing Fire. And if he's cautious about it, draws enough groves, you can't touch it with Surgical Extraction. And it just doesn't seem like there's enough outs.
Yep, he's gonna pay for it again without the groves. Give you a life, return the grove. Return the Punishing Fire via the grove. Cycle. Still leaving the grove up. Draw a card. Back over to Vuk. Another Mox Diamond. It's probably more important than one may realize.
Well, the Mox Diamond sort of gives Vuk the luxury of not having to care that much about Blood Moon, yep. even though he's still clutching the Abrupt Decay. The other thing about it is, it's his one way to jump ahead on mana. I mean, he's doing just fine in this game, but the more that he can get ahead on mana, make two land drops a turn effectively, then he can start doing things like actually cast one of his Planeswalkers on top of groving and looming and whatever else he wants to do.
Mm-hmm. Maybe a Planeswalker?
Yeah, it's probably Garrick, I'm guessing, again.
Yeah. Gonna make a wolf token, it looks like. So much to overcome. Again, it's what you mentioned too. You got the graveyard cut off, you got Chalice cutting off the ones, you got Punishing Fire cutting off some things, you got Garrick coming at you from essentially two angles because you have a Planeswalker that's generating tokens. You want to kill both.
Yep. Just creating, making the game about very narrow things.
If you mess up with your lands, he's gonna wasteland them. But eventually you get to a point where, if you're awesome, you have to do something.
Right.
If you do nothing, you're going to die. So it's like the walls are caving in from so many different directions.
So many of your draw steps are ineffectual.
Mm-hmm.
Just don't do anything. You have these Planeswalkers that really only have one mode on them. The ultimate.
Yeah.
And Punishing Fire makes that an impossibility.
This is going to be K command. I imagine destroy target artifact, make you discard. Okay. The Wasteland's going to take care of the Volcanic. So K command resolves.
But still no window here for Surgical Extraction.
Uh-uh. He ain't never going to give it to him.
Rossum knows. I mean, he knows at this point it's... He's just locked.
He's done. Matthew Vuk is going to win this game match against Jonathan Rossum. Four Color Loam is going to win this tournament here in Baltimore. Congratulations.